Okay, so I'm here. Okay, good. Let's wait for people to join. Okay, I see someone joining. It's good. Okay, so hello to people who have joined us. I'm Dr. Sahar. I'm pursuing my MD in psychiatry. And I'm here for today's live session with Dr. Al-Zanari. Right now, waiting for Sir to join. Once he's joined, I shall add him here. Sir is here, so gonna add. All right, waiting for Sir to join. Okay.
Hi,
Yeah,
hello.
now we're live. Good evening, sir.
Good evening, one and all present here in live. Good evening, Sahar.
Okay.
Hope you had a wonderful day.
Yes, sir. Hope you
Yeah.
did too, and hope everyone else did here as well. So
As of now, it's good. Thank you.
welcome to today's live session. And
Yeah.
as today is September 10th, it is also World Suicide Prevention Day. So today's live session will deal with how to recognize, assess suicidality, and also the big question, how can we prevent it? So we have Dr. Adhanari M, AP of Department of Psychiatry of MMCHRI, who has graciously joined us to answer some questions and help us shed some light on this big question.
Yeah, very good evening to one and all present here. I'm very happy to join Professional Helps to give this live interview on the occasion of World Suicide Prevention Day. And I would like to thank Mr. Pawan, who is the CEO of Professional Helps. And I also would like to extend my gratitude to Dr. Sahar, who is hosting the show today.
My pleasure.
And
Yes,
I
absolute pleasure.
welcome all the audience who has come here to listen to us and share and learn with us in this session of half an hour. Thanks a lot. To start with, I think we can go to the topic directly. Today
Yes,
being
sir.
World Suicide
Yes.
Prevention Day, suicides are becoming very common, and depression has been emerging as one of the major reasons for being the cause of suicidality in India. And it is becoming more and more every single year. The rate of suicide, completed suicide, is becoming more. The frustration tolerance and stress handling capacity of youngsters and older people, or elderly people, or middle-aged people, is constantly deteriorating, is what I feel. But what we need to do is, we as medical professional, we as human beings, has to support each other and try to prevent this as much as possible.
Definitely.
We need to bring back the humanity which is gradually declining in us. Most of us are interested in their own work. Even if somebody is depressed, we are very much scared to go and ask whether the person is depressed or not, whether they need any help or not, because we are all afraid that he will come and question us, "What is your business in my thing? Go and mind
Yes.
your own business." We are all afraid of that. Okay, fine, it is my business. Why can't we take it like that? It is
Yes.
my business to go and then prevent my species from becoming extinct.
Yes.
Suicide is, as it is becoming more and more common, don't you think that is one of the major reasons for extinction of human race also?
Of course, sir.
Due to
So,
the corona situation, due to the lockdown, the suicide rates also have been phenomenally, I mean, has increased drastically. And the frustration tolerance level of people have become, drastically down. And for even small things, people attempt or contemplate or complete suicides. Not only celebrities, common people are more affected by this. And what we are doing about this is something that we need to focus on today's session.
yes, sir.
Yeah.
So let's start off with the biggest question that everyone has when they feel that someone is suicidal or that someone is thinking of suicide. What is it that we can do when you feel this way about a friend or a family member?
As a common person, as a relative, as a friend, as a colleague, or whoever it might be, once when you suspect a person is having or expressing certain suicidal behavior, or certain behaviors which is indicative of suicidal behavior in that particular person, the first step that you need to take is to go and reach to that person. Try to go and communicate to that person, and it is okay to go and say that person that what you are trying to do, what you are thinking to do is wrong. It need not be done. That is the first thing that you can go and tell that person. Reassure that person that what you're doing is wrong. And there are multiple other ways to, handle your problems. This is not the only way. First is to extend your support and to make the other person realize whatever he is doing is wrong, and make him realize that he has support. He is not helpless. He is not hopeless, and he is not worthless. We need to make sure that we extend our support to them. That is the first thing that we need to do. Second thing is, like, if there is any parent or a, legal guardian for that particular person, it is extremely vital to go and inform that particular person that your ward is expressing these kind of behaviors, or I'm suspecting that your ward can contemplate suicide or get into that kind of an activity or a behavior. So it is extremely important for you to, communicate to that nearby person. In case if you are not able to communicate any other person, you can very well inform the police. That is also one of the helpful methods that you can think of. There is nothing wrong. You will know, you will not be put into trouble and all.
So
You're
we
just
can
trying
take
to
it.
help another person. You can always try and then, extend your help with whatever method that you want to. Later on, you can go and explain to that person, okay, I just did it for your good. Is
And
that
then,
okay?
another question that people do have is, what are the possible predictors of suicide? People who have committed or have attempted to commit, what could be the possible predictors
Yeah, the
they
most
can have?
common predictors of a suicidal behavior or suicidal tendency is that mostly people will be very withdrawn. They will isolate themselves from communicating with any other person. They will appear very dull most of the time. They will be very sad. They will keep to themselves. They will express or frequently talk about suicides and death and taking one's own life. Some people might even arrange for their funeral and their property and all. They might even start settling. Some people might express behavior like self-injurious behavior might be there, cutting themselves or hitting themselves in the head over the wall, slapping themselves, or they might try to harm themselves more. They might be not eating properly. They might be starving. They might not be sleeping properly. There might be frequent crying spells, or some people might even become very violent, or they might even be very irritable most of the time. That is also a possibility. When we think that, okay, fine, usually people try to get away from certain people when they are irritable or when they are violent. But suicidality or high suicidal tendencies might be the reason for this kind of a behavior also. They might think that, okay, anyways, I'm going to die in a few days or 1 or 2 days. So what is the point in me being nice? Or they are just worried, or they themselves are afraid of committing suicide. So they do not know how to express that, and then they try to become little agitated and violent. So these are some of the predictors that you can think, that you can notice in people who are having or expressing suicidal behavior. When you notice any of these things, it is always better to go and then help them.
So there is a definite warning signs which can be seen in suicidal people. So another question that they have is, can suicidality be genetically inherited?
Definitely, yeah. Suicidality can be genetically inherited is what you're asking, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. If there is a complete suicide in the family member, there is 50% more risk for suicidality to be present in their offsprings also, or in their siblings also. It makes it twofold more for those people to get or contemplate or have even a completed suicide. Contemplation of suicide itself increases the risk of people contemplating suicide. Completed suicide increases the risk furthermore.
Okay.
susceptibility to develop depression or susceptibility to have poor coping skills also is transmitted by genetics. If your mother or father is having poor coping skills, you tend to learn from them, and some might transmit it genetically to you also. So there is involvement of environmental and genetical factors. Adoption studies also says that suicidality evidences are definitely there. So suicides definitely have a genetic background also.
Okay, thank you, sir. Another is about the gender disparity. Why is it that men are more likely to commit suicide than women?
Yeah, completed suicides is what you mean.
Completed suicide. Why is it that men die more often than the suicide they commit?
Yeah, the severity or the intent of the suicide is usually little higher prevalent in case of males when compared to females. Females usually, though they have severe intent to commit suicide, there won't be much of the method of trying to commit suicide. No, that will differ from male and female. Usually, women will make choices which are less painful, or methods of suicide which are less painful. Men usually will try methods which are more painful and more gruesome
And foolproof.
because of the violent nature in their genes itself, or in their hormonal role, because of their hormonal influences. Usually, violent deaths are more common in men. Violent methods are also being practiced more in men. And there is involvement of intoxication also. Substance induced suicidality is also there, no? So all these things make men to commit more number in suicides than when compared to women. Since women usually prefer less painful methods like ingestion of overdose of drugs or
First.
medicines, poisons, or they call it arali and all. So all these things usually are practiced by women.
So
Self
you talked
immolation,
about
yeah, self immolation and hanging,
okay.
cutting themselves, drowning, all these things are usually chosen by men. Yeah.
So you brought up a point about alcohol and drugs used, the propensity is more in men. So how does this affect suicidality and how,
Yeah,
like,
complete your question.
suicidality and the propensity to commit suicide, how does it affect how of like the how much tendency is there to commit the suicide?
If there is a small delay in the connectivity, I think there is a small lag in the connectivity. That's why I'm not able to get it clearly. If I'm not wrong, is the question like what is the role of substance abuse in suicidality?
Yes, sir.
Is that the question?
Definitely.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Any
Yes, sir.
substance use, increases the impulsivity of a patient, of a person. Any substance use impairs the judgment of a person. So these both are major features which cause or promote or which facilitate suicidal behavior, or the intensity and the the gruesomeness of the suicidal behavior or the completion of the suicide attempt is facilitated by these two things. The impulsivity of the patient is increased, and also the judgment of the patient or of the person is grossly impaired whenever they are under the influence of any substance. Take it marijuana, take it alcohol, take it any form of drug abuse, their judgment is going to be grossly impaired. And they are going to be more impulsive in nature. And most of the drugs are CNS depressants also. That will further increase the suicidal thoughts or suicidal behavior. So this might be one of the major causes for suicides under intoxication.
Okay. This
Yes,
is
sir.
an interesting question. What is a suicide contagion and how can it be prevented? So could you hear
Hello?
me?
Yeah,
Can you
you're
hear me,
breaking
sir?
a little bit. You're breaking a little bit. I'll wait for the question.
Okay. It's question is, what is suicide contagion and how can it be prevented?
Suicide contagion and how can it be prevented, or
Yes,
predicted?
sir. Prevented is what was asked, but whatever makes sense in
Yeah,
terms of the
but
answer,
prevented
sir.
would be better. Yeah, suicide contagion is nothing but when somebody is exposed to suicides or suicidal behavior through media or through an immediate family member, through peer groups or through friends. That is what you call as suicide contagion. When you get exposed yourself to this kind of a behavior or this kind of a act, the tendency of people who are already having suicidal ideas will further increase or worsen whenever they see or whenever they get themselves exposed to these kind of things. Do you get it?
Okay.
So that
Yes,
is what you
sir.
call
So,
as a
for example,
suicide contagion.
okay, sir. For
Yeah,
example,
when
right now the country is going through something similar with the suicide of a celebrity. So, a contagion would be when similar depressed individuals or people who are having more tendency to commit suicide would go ahead and do the deed.
Yeah, I would say that more than the exposure of suicide, the currently things are going into character assassination of a person. Nowadays, a person cannot even be happy even after the death. People continuously bombard their character and then they try to explore what has happened, what has not happened. What is the point in all these things? I don't know. It has to be treated like yet another case because it is not only celebrities who are doing this. Every single person who has done something like this is a human being. Their life matter. Is it
Yes.
not? We give so much of importance to that particular thing. Of course, his life is also extremely important. But why don't we treat that with a lot of dignity and decorum?
Yes, sir.
People are making it like a show. It is
Yes.
not an entertainment. It is something that you should feel bad for. Agreed. Everybody feels bad. But is that the only thing which is happening?
No, there is much more to
Ten
it.
days we are all sitting and then exposing ourselves to something like that. It is not a good decision that he had taken. We all regret that. We all are feeling bad for that. But every human being deserves another one chance, right? We cannot sit there. We cannot keep on be worrying about what we have lost. We need to focus on something that we already have. And we need to focus on things that we should not lose anymore. So, what is that we have learned from this? To find out why he had died? Is that what is important to us? To us as normal, common people, what we need to get from this is that there is no need for somebody to do something like that. There is so much of support. Even if a person decides to take away his life, there is so much of support. Had he come out to ask for help, had people gone to help him, it would have made more sense. That is the message that we need to take from this. We need to see to that there is no other person who unnecessarily becomes a celebrity like this.
Definitely, sir.
They don't want, this is not something to name as a celebrity has done something like that. He is a normal human being like you and me. He was smiling, he was happy, he was living his own life. He wanted to die, he took a bad decision. Fine. But it is none of our business actually. What our business would have been is we could have prevented it. If we were aware of that, we could have prevented it. But how many of us are actually trying to prevent something like that? The take-home lesson from this particular celebrity's death is that after this, no person should, commit suicide. If you come to know that some person is expressing some kind of a suicidal behavior, we should extend our help. we should be
Yes,
available for them to bring them out of it.
absolutely.
Even if it is costing us some amount of financial loss, it is just a financial loss. You can always get it back.
Yes, sir.
Nothing is going to compensate for saving a person's life.
Absolutely.
Is it not? So that is something that I would like to stress upon in this area.
Yes, sir. To prevent more such incidents rather than dig up what has happened.
Yeah, and about the suicide contagion prevention, when you come to know that somebody is exposed to something like this, first we need to find out what is the source of the contagion, like media, like a peer group, like a family member or a friend. Who is the one person who has done something like that? Okay, first we need to treat that particular person who has exposed other people to that. Okay, then we need to take that particular person and the group of people who have exposed themselves to this kind of a scenario to a psychiatrist or a medical facility to do proper assessment for them in case if there is any probability for them to have any suicidal ideas or depression or any kind of mental illness. We need to make sure it becomes better and we treat that. So that would be one of the major things that you could do to prevent
Okay, sir. I
suicide
think we have.
contagion.
Okay, thank you, sir. That was well explained. I think we have time for one last question, which is
Yeah.
quite interesting one also. Why is it that people don't talk about mental illness? As psychiatrists, we see mental illness all the time, but it is well known that in our society it is still considered much of a taboo. So why is it so that you feel?
Yeah, for eons, people have been thinking that mental illness is something that is supernatural, something that is a bogus, or something that we are deluded about. But people need to understand that a delusion itself is a disorder which needs to be treated. People don't think that people don't give importance to their own mental health. People think that just because they think they have the willpower, they can always come out of it. Of course, they can if they really want to, if they really try to. But people don't really try to come out of their problems. They don't try to resolve any conflicts that they are having internally. They try to, leave it aside and then try to concentrate or focus on something else. But how long can you do that? How long can you do that? Mental illness or depression is also something which is very, very common, like diabetes and hypertension. In fact, I would say it is more common than that. In a currently studies, certain studies says that every house that has at least two people who are depressed, who are at least susceptible to go into depression. At least one person is having a susceptibility to develop depression. So if that is so common, why can't we give importance to that? Luckily, for the past 20, 30 years, the awareness about mental illness and the treatment modalities about the depression and other things have become much better. People, as long as they think that magical religious treatment is the only way to come out of mental illness, there is no way that people can be saved. They, with all due respect to whatever religious sentiments people have, even I am a religious person. Even I go to temples. I pray. I am a spiritual person. I'm not telling no. But the thing is, like, why can't you just pray and then take the help also?
Absolutely.
Why can't you take that God is guiding us into this particular way to bring us out
Absolutely.
of it?
God
Is it
helps
not?
those who
So,
help themselves is what.
those who want to help themselves.
Yes, sir.
Is it not?
Definitely.
God always gives you a reason to become better person, but it depends whether you want to take it or not. At the end
Definitely.
of the day, you cannot go and complain anybody other than yourself. Whatever I've done, I am responsible for whatever I'm going through. So I can always take the decision to make myself a better person. What is there wrong?
Yes.
People, don't mind when they have cancer. People don't mind. Oh, leave cancer at least. People don't mind to go and get treated when they have HIV. People don't mind when they be less careful and then get infected with certain diseases and then go get treated. But this is very, very simple. This is not something that can get communicated. This is something that you are developing, from inside yourself. Why can't you just go and then say to another person, "Yeah, I am depressed, but I want to become better." If you just take that one step, you can definitely prevent everything. And there is also a taboo that usually psychiatrists will keep people on medication for a very, very long time. For a major depressive episode, maximum period of duration for taking medication is usually 2 years only. In mild cases, medication might not be even necessary.
Yes, sir.
Counseling methods and cognitive behavior therapy itself can bring them out of their depression. When it is moderate to severe, or when it is moderate, usually about 1 year of treatment is more than enough. Usually, patients will become completely all right within 3 to 6 months of starting the medication. Why are we giving for the next 6 months? So that the person need not develop, or will the probability of the person developing the same illness in future is very much less when you take it for a period of 1 year. That we call as maintenance phase. We maintain it gradually, taper it, and stop. But people become, non-compliant very frequently. When they become non-compliant, the recurrence of the disease also becomes more. Severity of the disease also becomes very much more. And people, the drugs also become little, say for example, resistant. The patients become resistant to certain drugs. So we are forced to increase the drugs dosage, or change the drug which has a higher side effect profile. So all these things are being forced upon certain doctors who want to try and do a genuine practice.
Yes.
No doctor wants to keep the patient for throughout their life.
Yes, sir,
I'll be called a good
definitely.
doctor only when I make your problem better. I want you to
So
work,
this
I want you to get back to your normalcy as soon as possible. Only then I can be called as a good doctor, right? Every
Yes.
proper good psychiatrist will want to do something like that.
Yes.
But a person can actually come out of their problem only if they help from their side also. That is absolutely necessary and important.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So these misconceptions can be cleared when like people from our audience, you and I, every layman starts talking more about how they are feeling and learning more about what the disease is and how to deal with it, rather than getting scared and or being embarrassed about it. Okay, I think we can end our session here, sir. Thank you so much
There is no
for
need for embarrassment and all, because it is something that we are experiencing on a day-to-day life. We are hurt, we are troubling, and we are looking for a way to get out of it. So we can always go and then take help and come out with your head held high, saying that I was somebody who survived depression. I fought depression, I came out of depression. That is something that you can always proudly say. And I would like to end my speech by saying that happiness is a choice that you make. I always say this wherever I go. Happiness is not something that somebody can take it away or give to you. Only you are the one who is responsible for your own happiness. So always choose happiness and choose to be happy.
okay. Thank you
Thanks a
so much.
lot for giving a wonderful opportunity. I would like to thank Sahar. I would like to thank Pavan also for giving this wonderful opportunity. And I would like to thank my team 90 Decibels also for organizing such a wonderful conference. Of all, I would like to personally thank all the audience for such patient listening and such great comments. Thanks a lot.
Okay. Thank you, sir. And thank you to
Have a
Mr.
good
Pavan.
day.
Okay. Thank you.
Have a good day. Yeah, bye bye.
Bye.